Hello friends, I am Prashant Vishwanath Dhanshetti, Assistant Professor, Department of Civil Engineering from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today I am here you to explain about the Rankines formula for the crippling load. The learning outcome of today's lecture is student will be able to derive the crippling load of column by using Rankines formula. The compression member, it may be a strut or a column which is subjected to axial compressive load, whereas column is a structural member which is vertical and both its ends are fixed while subjected to axial compressive load. The failure of columns may be due to direct compressive stress if the column is a short column. The short column is the column when the length to its least lateral dimension is lesser than 12, and the long column will fail by buckling stress. So long column will be the column when the ratio of length to least lateral dimension is greater than 12. So the column in between long and short, it may fail by combined effect of direct compressive stress and buckling. Crippling stress in terms of effective length and radius of gyration. The moment of inertia can be written as I is equals to AK square, where K is the radius of gyration and A is the cross-sectional area. I is the least moment of inertia, hence K will be also the least radius of gyration. We know the Euler's formula for the crippling load. It is given by P is equals to pi square EI upon L effective square. So now in place of I, we will write as AK square. Writing that, what we will get is pi square EI into AK square upon L effective square. So if I take this K in the denominator, what I will get, P is equals to pi square E into A upon L by K bracket square. Now the crippling stress is equals to crippling load divided by area. So putting that value in P by A, what we will get here is pi square EA upon L upon K bracket square. So as AA will get cancelled, and L upon K is the slenderness ratio. It is the ratio of length of column to least radius of gyration. So where K will be taken as under root I minimum upon area. So limitation of Euler's formula. So we know the Euler's formula. It is given as pi square A upon L effective upon K bracket square. So considering both ends hinge, L effective is equals to L. Hence crippling stress is pi square A upon L upon K bracket square, where L by K is the slenderness ratio. So if L by K is small, then the crippling stress would be very high, as it is a denominator. If it is very small, so you will get the crippling stress very high, that may be greater than the crushing stress also. So but for material, the crippling stress cannot be greater than the crushing stress. So when slenderness ratio is less than a certain limit, Euler formula gives a value of crippling stress which is greater than crushing stress. That cannot be accepted. Now for example, if we consider a mild steel column with both ends hinged having crushing stress 330 Newton per mm square and modulus of elasticity 2 into 10 raised to 5 Newton per mm square. So now if we equate the crippling stress to the crushing stress, pi square E upon L upon K bracket square is equals to 330. So putting the value of E, so we will get L upon K square is equals to pi square into 2.1 into 10 raised to 5 divided by 350. So taking the square root of both the terms, L upon K is equals to 79.27, say nearly equals to 80. So now hence the slenderness ratio, if it is less than 80, then the mild steel column with both ends hinged, then Euler formula will not be valid. So it will give the crippling load greater than the crushing load. Now, column type and failure. So, when we will consider column as a long column or short column, and when the failure of long column will occur, or how will it occur, and failure of short column occurs by. Here, pause the video and try to write answer on a paper. A column having the ratio of length to least lateral dimension greater than 12 is called as long column. A column having ratio of length to least lateral dimension less than 12 is called as short column. Failure of long column occurs by buckling, whereas failure of short column occurs by crushing. Now, Rankine's formula. So, Euler formula gives correct result only for long column. So, when the column is short or the column is not very long, the formula will not give the correct results. So, based on experiments performed by Rankine, he established an empirical formula which will be applicable for both types of column. So, the Rankine's formula is given by 1 upon P is equals to 1 upon PC plus 1 upon PE. So, we will treat it as equation number 2, where P is the crippling load by Rankine's formula, and PC is the crushing load, and PE is the Euler's load, or crippling load by Euler's formula. So, sigma C is, will be the ultimate crushing stress, and A will be the cross-sectional area. Now, we know the Euler's load, that is crippling load by Euler's, it is pi square A upon L effective square. So, here sigma C is constant and area is also constant. So, the PC will be constant because PC will be stress, crushing stress into area. As both these are constant, this will be constant. The value of PC is constant, hence the value of P majorly depends upon this value of P, that is the Euler's crippling load formula. Now, we'll consider case 1 when the column is short. So, PE, that is Euler's crippling load, is given by pi square A upon L effective square, and the Rankine's formula is given by 1 upon P is equals to 1 upon PC plus 1 upon PE. So, if L effective is small, then the value of PE will be large. So, L effective, it is in the denominator. So, when it is very small, this PE will be large. When this PE will be large, then 1 upon PE will be small. So, 1 upon PE in Rankine's formula, it will be small. So, it is negligible as compared to PC. Hence, when the column is short, so 1 upon P is proportional to 1 upon PC. Therefore, the crippling load will be equal to crushing load. Hence, crippling load by Rankine's formula is approximately equals to crushing load. Now, case 2, when the column is long. So, P is equals to again pi square A upon L effective square, and Rankine's formula 1 upon P is equals to 1 upon PC plus 1 upon PE. So, here if the column is long, L effective is large. As it is in the denominator, so this PE, crippling load by Euler's, will be small. So, when it is small, 1 upon PE will be large enough when compared with 1 upon PC. Hence, we can neglect 1 upon PC in equation number 2. Then we will get 1 upon P is equals to 1 upon PE, or P is equals to PE. Hence, the crippling load by Rankine's formula is approximately equal to crippling load by Euler's formula. Now, again, we will take 1 upon P is equals to 1 upon PC plus 1 upon PE. So, now for all lengths of column, so we will cross multiply it. So, PE plus PC is divided by PE into PC is equals to 1 upon P. Now, taking the reciprocal to both the sides and dividing numerator and denominator by PE. So, what we will get? 1 upon P's reciprocal is P, and here P into C divided by PE, I will get PC here. Again, PE divided by PE will be 1, and PC divided by P here it will be as it is. So now again, but we know that PC is equals to sigma C into A and PE is equals to pi square EI upon L effective square. So now putting this value in this above equation, we will get P is equals to sigma C into A upon 1 plus sigma C divided by into bracket pi square EI upon L effective square. Here I is equals to AK square. So if we put I is equals to AK square, so we will get P in terms of radius of gyration also. P is equals to sigma C into A upon 1 plus sigma C upon pi square E into bracket L effective upon K bracket square. So now this term sigma C upon A 1 plus alpha into bracket L effective upon K square is equals to P is equation B. So here alpha will be equal to sigma C upon pi square E, where alpha is known as Rankine's constant, and this formula gives the crippling load by Rankine's formula. So these are the references which I have referred. Thank you very much for watching my video.